All right, guys, so I'll nitpick some stuff that we talked about earlier in classroom in the first game. Paul, right now at trail, like we talked about, white line, get down there. There you go. And start there, stay there, and you can still work a couple steps up or down from there at the trail position. They want us to start 28-foot line. We can open up and kind of go from there rather than being behind the play. Probably a foul there on the drive. He gets beat, body bump. Yeah, he kicked it out and passed it away, but that's one where we can look at, I don't want to say advantage, disadvantage there, but okay, he got by the defender, gets pushed through the back. If he goes up with that, I for sure am calling that a foul. So take a look at that one, Phil. And here's where we should rotate over. Ball's all the way down there in the post. I would have got over there right away. Still kind of, 15 was our post matchup. You can always go with them around. I know this team is shooting a ton of threes, but that's one there. The post is over there. Ball settles over there. Let's rotate over. I've got a tendency to kind of step on the court when at lead when the ball is kind of going in. I would urge you to kind of try to stay off of it. Keep your feet settled, be a little more still. So there, if the ball truly does go on the sideline, let the trail take that. Especially inbounding here. All right, well, if we put it on the baseline, then we're fine with it going out there, and I'm fine with Leeds' call. on, Phil, just in terms of mechanic-wise, I would go up to the strictest, drop the whistle out of your mouth, start going to the reporting area, and then that's where you get the foul with the signal block. I think on that one, we don't need a preliminary signal, and then also you don't you can verbalize, too. You don't necessarily have to put two fingers up. That's something they've tried to skew away from as well. But just little things like that to kind of clean up the flow of the foul. So fist up, drop the whistle, you can say two shots. Everyone knows where you're going. Players hear the verbal cue of two shots. They start lining up. Your partners get the shooter for you, and you kind of move on from there. Good call. So he goes up there, he's pitched over him. So watch 32 and 9 in the post there. Watch him trying to hook, hold, cheap stuff. Two non-post players trying to play the post. good rotations. They're on the swings, so pretty much you're going to follow that post player around the ball settle, and I think you guys are doing a good job of recognizing when to rotate on the center of the court. Just remember to stop the clock every time. And it goes up, then point. Good call. Absolutely. So that's it, Phil. Look at the mechanic reporting at the table there. That's, you'll get that call maybe twice a year. Just talk through the steps with yourself and maybe practice that one again, just to how you could do that, that different to clean that up. That's one there. Look at that play again. I'm happy you went and finished it. You could almost have a foul in transition on 32 for playing lazy defense. I know that's not in the rule book, but he kind of reaches in once. He kind of pushes him again. You can tell he's frustrated. That's one where, you know, I'm fine either way we do. Either we call that foul right away, or we let him and hopefully gets to the rack and puts it in the way he does. Get your three-point signal up and closer together with the arms. They're not making the wide goals. Just look at the mechanic of that one. Try to clean that up a little bit. Absolutely. That's one, Phil, might be able to rotate over there to ourselves in that position. We had eight guys on that side of the court. Might have been a good time to rotate earlier. Might have that drive. But here, make sure you're not watching ball out there, Phil. You're responsible for that post matchup. Let Paul take that outside play. Phil, your last second shot, opposite table. Right now I'd be tapping my chest to let my partners know I have it.
here, okay. When, you know, because that, you know, ball is kind of swinging out there.
Right.
I'm a little closer.
Okay.
Because that way, if that ball does get over there, I need to settle. I can take a step.
You're here when the ball is where? When the ball is like.
I never get outside of here.
Oh, okay, okay. So you just opening up that grip.
That's kind of what I was talking about before.
Right, right. Okay, okay.
Because why I do that is because then if the ball gets maybe that wing, I'll close down where I'm here.
Right.
Okay, now I can go and I can take three steps and I'm across.
Right.
Rather than
doing a long step.
Because then here, if it goes and it comes back around,
right.
I'm right back here.
Okay.
And I'm open. Like.
Right. That's what you're
just kind of, you know, I don't know what the best cue is, but just think about just trying it.
Right. Yeah. I'm gonna
Everyone's going to find their own spot that they want to live in.
Right. Right.
But just, I think the more comfortable you can be in one spot and kind of turning and opening it up,
right.
It's a little pivot.
Okay. Okay.
Absolutely. I call it every single time. Every time.
Good call.
Take a look at that again. I am 86 feet away from that play. I don't know if that contact to the defender's chest made his arms go down and then he hits him. Just a play that I want, you know, I'm not saying right, wrong, or different here. Just take a look at that one and see what action caused what. It could have been a foul. It could have been a shooting foul. I'm not saying it wasn't. Just take a peek at those. Those are things that I would almost stress. Let's have a patient whistle. We can replay it in our head at least once, and we can still come out and get a foul if it's a foul. That's got to be a foul. Good call. Okay, good. I would agree that's a foul on the secondary defender, nine, not the kid that was stationary in the lane. I'm fine with that C call coming from the C side, going there the whole way. Phil, that's where you can be closed down on that lane line like we just talked about. You got secondary help, so your primary guy is the one that was stationary in the lane. That's the guy that you're watching for, and Nick has the foul on the guy coming from the outside. That wasn't really legal and kind of leaning in. So, Paul, this is one where your post matchup's kind of on the other side there, and you're look at your eyes now and try not to watch that ball. I think you guys are doing a real good job with this swing offense, recognizing where it's kind of going, where it's coming from, and really refereeing that the right way. So I think rotation-wise, we're doing a good job. Just that one, I always want you to kind of watch your head during the course of that offensive set. Phil, watch that one. I'm going to challenge you again at the spot of the foul. Whistle with a fist up, and then just get your buns over the table and report it. Figure out the best way to do that. Drop that whistle and start hustling over there or something, so that way you're not at the spot giving more increased preliminary signals. I just think it's going to look smooth. I think if you polish up some of those attributes like we've been talking about this weekend, you're going to be set. That's where we're going to rotate there. I know there's no post over there, but that ball's all the way over in the corner. We got to go. Even if the ball's coming back, I think we got to get over there. Good call. 32 is the king of lazy defense. whistle. Yep. A foul up top there. So we probably got to have a foul there, but the dude getting thrown into the scorer's table, probably look at that one. So on that, let's so we have a double foul. We resume play with point interruption. So that's where we just need to determine, okay, was it still on the inbounds pass? If it still was before the ball left the thrower in's hands, then we can go back to point interruption, which is black ball, spot throw-in. If that ball's out of his hands and it's a loose ball, then that's where we go to alternating possession arrow. And on that foul again, too, yes, there was a lot of contact, but I want us to look, is that truly a double foul? Did the defense initiate that contact? What is it? So just look at that. I'm not opposed to a double foul there, but at time and place, knowing that the defense wants to foul, is that something we can get away with just a defensive foul? The other thing to look at, too, is that crap that happened when the two were on the ground, and you know they were getting chippy. They were all pissed off at each other, and the kid in black thought he got pushed down again, but it was the only teammate that actually pushed him down. So that's where you jump in there right away, use your voice, be loud, talk to them so they know that you're watching so nothing stupid happens.